Hi guys, today we will be taking a look at position report. What do we need to include in a position report? So there are six components of a position report. The first one is the aircraft identification. The second is the position, the time over, the flight level or altitude or past or clear level or passing level, the next position and time over, the ensuing significant point. So the first one, if we take the aircraft identification, is usually the call sign. For example, Springbok 545. Let's say it's at any position that he is passing. Example, Xabi, and time would be the time he passed the point or crossed the point, abeam the point. I will give you, we will take an example of 0645. The flight level, if he is maintaining a flight level or passing a flight level or clear the flight level. So for this one, we will be taking a he will be maintaining a flight level of 360. And the next position would be Espire, and the time over will be the estimated time for Espire would be 0720, and the ensuing significant point will be Topaz. Ensuing significant point is usually the next significant point along the intended route after the time waypoint. So I hope, but ensuing significant point, in reality they don't really use it, but it is important. So if we take an example, it should be like this: Springbok 545, Xabi 0545, maintaining flight level 360, SP 0720, Topaz. Next position, Topaz. So I hope this video was helpful for you guys, and see you at the next one. Bye bye.